Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Stellarium to measure how high the sun is in the sky at midday. So in other words, the sun's angle above the horizon at midday. That's as high as it gets in the sky. So I'm going to share my screen.
Stellarium controls are located on the left and bottom of the screen. The contrast is poor when Stellarium is showing daytime mode. Look for a bright red arrow followed by a number indicating the icon's position relative to the list, starting from the top or the left.
So here we are in Stellarium, and the first thing we need to do is acquire the sun. So again, go to the search window, type in sun and enter, and it will find it in the sky. The next thing you need to do is pick your location on the planet. And we're going to do a variety of locations, most of which you're going to pick, though we begin with an example, and that example is Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Again, that's where Skynet is headquartered. But in the example I'm showing you now, I'm not going to do Chapel Hill. I'll let you do that one on your own. I don't want to give away the answer. So instead, I will pick a different location. Maybe I'll pick Pasadena, California, where I did my postdoc. Okay, I'm in Pasadena. I'm going to close this out. And now we're going to do this for summer solstice in this particular example. So I go to the date. I'm going to set that to June 21st. And, you know, as you do other cities, you'll do summer solstice, you'll do winter solstice, and you'll do the equinoxes as well. But in this example, we're going to measure how high the sun is in the sky in Pasadena at midday on the summer solstice. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to scroll out so we can see the whole sky. And I like to put south on the bottom. We have S here to denote south. And you can see we're not at midday. At midday, the sun would be right over here, halfway between east and west. So I can change the time, maybe somewhere around there, approximately. But to get it precisely, we're going to go over here and read well, it's hard to see because the text is on the ground. So another hint here is if we come down here and click on this eye, that's night mode. A lot of astronomers and amateur astronomers use this software program Stellarium at their telescopes, and they don't want the bright light from the computer screen to mess up their night vision. So there's this kind of night mode or red mode, and it's easier to read the text here. So what we want is the apparent altitude. So over here we have azimuth, altitude. So right here, the second number is the altitude. It's currently 39 degrees up. In fact, I'm just going to stop time from running right there. 7900, and I'm going to adjust the time to maximize this. So that brought it down. It's now 7857. They'll go the other direction. And the arc minutes are still increasing. Now they're decreasing. Right there. And I'm not going to really worry about the seconds. We can if we want. Somewhere around there. That's as high in the sky. So 12:54. It doesn't happen exactly at noon. It depends where you are in the time zone, if you're using daylight savings time or not, things of that nature. But we're not looking for the time. We're actually looking for the altitude. That's as high as the sun is in the sky. And that's 79 degrees, 17 arc minutes. And in the WebAssign lab, you're supposed to enter that to the nearest number of degrees. So if it's over 30 arc minutes, you round up. If it's under 30 arc minutes, you round down. Okay. That is how you do that.